So today we are going to discuss a distillation problem. 8000 kg per hour of a mixture, benzene and toluene, containing 30% by weight of a benzene, is to be fractionated into distillate containing 97% by weight of a benzene and residue containing 99% by weight of a toluene. The feed enters at its boiling point. Design the distillation column. So here in a distillation column problem, you always think about the feed. So it is given in kg per hour. If it is given in a weight percent, so try to convert that into moles per hour or kilomoles per hour. Okay, that is very, very important aspect in a distillation design. And I have already discussed how to take XY data. If it is given in the problem, you take it. Otherwise, you refer a page number 18.3 in Perry handbook and you will get a XY data. And also in Perry handbook, temperature of this composition is also given. You can write that also, okay, if it is needed. Okay, we have taken XY data from Perry handbook for a benzene and toluene. So that data is not directly available. So refer to the diagram where benzene and toluene equilibrium curve is given. What we are doing, we are locating X and calculating the Y. So similarly, we are doing it from 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 up to 1. So the values of Y is calculated. Okay. Here, feed is 800 kg per hour. So therefore, if you want to convert it to kilomole, so feed contains the 30% benzene and 70% toluene. So you can take an average molecular weight, 30% of benzene and 30% of toluene. Before that, so 30% it is by weight. So I am converting this by a moles, mole percent. Here it is weight percent. So therefore 0.3 by 7.8. So what is total? 0.3 is benzene, 0.7 is benzene. So therefore I am dividing this by molecular weight of benzene, molecular weight of benzene, molecular weight of toluene. XF is 0.3357. And average molecular weight is, this into 78, 1 minus this into 92, 87.3. If you divide 87.3 for feed, you will get kilomole per hour. So 8000 divided by 87.8 kilomole per hour. So XT similarly, it is again by weight. So XT is top product. So benzene is coming. So therefore, benzene is a more volatile component, 0.97. If it is 0.97 in a distillate, how much will be there in residue? So 1 minus 0.97. So means 0.03 is present in a XW. Okay. So for XD, 0.97 divided by 78, whole divided by 0.97 divided by 78 plus 0.03 divided by 92 is equal to 0.9744. XD is 0.9744. And XW is given in the problem statement. Okay. So you can check XW. XW is CF. 99% is toluene. So how much is remaining? 1% of benzene is remaining. So therefore, you have to take 0.01 divided by 78, 0.01 divided by 78, 0.99 divided by 92. It is more in toluene bottom. So on the top distillate, it will be more in benzene. Therefore, benzene is more volatile component and toluene is less volatile component. And do the overall balance, F is equal to D plus W. So therefore, 91.63. D plus W, So component balance, you substitute all the value. So you can write, D or W value here, substitute. You can write one more, thing. W is equal to 91.63 minus D. Okay. You substitute this equation here. And then solve, you will get W is equal to 60.73. D is equal to 30.86. Okay. I hope you understood this material balance. Coming to the next. So what you should do? So you have to plot XY data. This is from a VLE data. First, what you do? So take one unit is equal to 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 up to 1. And here also it is 0.1, 0.2 up to 1. Okay. Make a square and then draw a diagonal line. So draw a diagonal line. Okay. And then these are the points I am locating. So based on the XY data, So X is 0.1, Y is 0.2. So X is 0.2, Y is 0.38. I'll show one point. X is 0.1, Y is 0.2. x is 0.2, y is 0.38. Okay, similarly you do it and join this line. Join this line. Okay, I'll show in the next slide. And then also you know the value of xw. Xw composition will be here, xf will be somewhere here, and xd will be somewhere here. Okay, once again we'll go back and see. So what is xf? 0.3357, xd is 0.9744, and xw is 0.0117. So these points should be located on the graph. So therefore I have drawn the equilibrium curve and I have located xw as 0.117, xd as 0.3357, you can see here, and xd is 0.9744. I have located, and locate and extend this line. Use a scale and cut this diagonal line. So cut this diagonal line and then cut this diagonal line. Okay. So this is the next step. Okay. This is the value of x, this is the value of y. Okay. Next, see here. What is given? Feed. So this is a point where the Q line will be varying. Suppose, I'll just show. I think this is already discussed, but see here. So this is a point of a feed plate, how the material will enter. Suppose if the material is boiling, so material means feed is boiling at its, enters at its boiling point, this should be straight. And then if it is, feed is subcooled, it will be here. Supercooled, it will be here. And then vapor will be here. Superheated vapor, it will be here. So these are the lines of a feed line. And then please remember, if it is not given, then always assume the feed at its boiling point. Okay. So what you have done now, cut here, xf you are stopping here, xw you are stopping here. So we have located the point. And then you are extending this feed line based on the feed condition. Feed is at its boiling point. So therefore this will be, okay. In this case, what is, so because we want to calculate operating line for a enriching section. If you draw any line from here, it is operating line for an enriching section. It will be like this. If you draw anything from this point, then it is an operating line for a stripping section. First, what we are going to do? Operating line for an enriching section. See here, operating line for enriching section. So what is it? It is usually in the graph y-axis, we will get the intercept. So that is equal to xt divided by r plus 1. R plus 1. But please check the problem for r. If it is not given, if r is not given, you can calculate from this graph. So calculate the r from this graph. So how it can be calculated? Because r is a amount of a reflex going back to the column, and it will be based on the feed condition, based on the feed composition. So because at benzene it is a 30%, it is entering, and then from that point, see here. So this is what benzene at liquid at this point. So therefore reflex means it is coming from the top where it become a vapor. So therefore this is a vapor composition. So therefore you go here and cut this point, the corresponding value is y dash. So note down this y dash. Y dash is equal to 0.55, right? Okay, so therefore you can calculate r is equal to xd minus y dash. This is the equation to calculate r. Y dash minus x, that's it. Y dash, if it is not given. If it is given, directly take the value of r. So this is a method of calculation of r, because for the intercept, we want the xd divided by r plus 1. Okay. First, what you do, draw the equilibrium curve, locate xd, xf and xw, extend this point, and then based on the feed condition, draw the Q line. So this is called a Q line. Here, reflex ratio is not given. So reflex ratio will be depends upon the feed condition. So this is a composition at liquid, it is composition at the vapor, and calculate R is equal to XT minus Y dash divided by Y dash minus XF. I'll show that calculation here. Okay, so here intercept is equal to XT divided by R plus 1. So therefore R is not given. So therefore what I'll do, so take R is equal to 2.2 times R minimum. Okay, assume if it is not given. See here, it is not given in the problem statement. Okay, it is not given. Okay, therefore then only you can assume like this. So please remember. Okay, otherwise refer, sometime it will be given, all the values will be given. Here it is not given, therefore first I'll calculate RM, and then what I am assuming, reflex ratio is 2.2 times the R minimum. What is R minimum? It is XT minus Y dash, Y dash minus XF. Y dash value is 0.555. okay, so XT, you know, put the value of XT. Y dash is 0.555 and Y dash is 0.355 and XF is 0.3357. so therefore you will get R minimum as 1.9124. so therefore it is R minimum. So therefore what is R? R is equal to 2 times the R minimum. So therefore if you multiply this by 2, okay, so this will be somewhere. Okay, calculate this. Okay, I have made some mistake over here. Okay, so please check this R value. And otherwise, if you don't take, so you can take directly this value and do the calculation. Okay, that is also good. So see here, R is equal to 4.2072. Okay, so here it is. Okay, okay. XT is, sorry, so this line should be 4 point something. Okay, this should be 4.1. okay, here, sorry, by mistake I have taken this. Okay, once again I'll take yes. Okay, so here you calculate intercept. Intercept is 4.2. okay, you locate 4.2 over here and join this line and this line, sorry, 4.2, join this line and this line. Join this line and this line, and this is a XT divided by R plus 1. XT divided by R plus 1. So what is this? This is an operating line for a stripping section. Sorry, enriching section. Operating line for a enriching section. Okay. So now you got this point, right? Okay, somewhere here. And you join this point and this point. Yes. Okay, you got this line now. This line and this line. So this is a line for a operating. So therefore, this is an operating line for a stripping section, and this is an operating line for a stripping section. And draw the number of plates. Now you draw the number of plates from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six here, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, here actually you will not get more number of plates. I think that you will get the actual number of theoretical plates will be 10. Okay, this is how you can calculate number of theoretical plates. So first you will calculate XT divided by R plus 1. And wherever it is meeting the point of feed line, so draw this line and XWN and draw the number of theoretical plates. So this will be minus 1 because this is for the reboiler duty. So please, all of you, okay, solve this and keep your graph ready. Then we'll continue with the next class.